Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Red Card Podcast. We will be partially covering the news this week in the Pokemon community and all of the crazy stuff that's been happening, but there is no strict schedule. We will have segments, but we will flow in and out of them through the cloud of insanity. With me is High Voltage, returning, and also a random guest, Aria, a friend from my drawing and animation community. Hello, everyone, and please introduce yourselves.
Ladies first.
Hi, I'm Aria. I do stuff online. Done. You're next.
That was fast. Hi, I'm High Voltage. I have a YouTube channel, and I do everything from bad decks to Call of Duty to Let's Plays, only Deus Ex right now, though. And 60-second Let's Plays. Also, I have a podcast called the You're a Podcast. And yeah, that's about quickly what I do.
All right. Everyone, please settle in for a totally very strict, scheduled, organized podcast. I'm just kidding. We're going to say where the fuck we're going. So first off, Aria, go and watch Voltage. Can you send her... in the chat, the two trailers.
I have to go. I'm shuffling over to my computer now.
I want to hear a live reaction about the new region and everything. Because, like, when are you gonna hear a person who's not really following Pokemon and everything give their opinion on the new games? You know.
True.
There you go. She's not a very rabid fan.
That cute.
So we'll have her squeals and reactions to the new Alola region and all that stuff. And especially with, as soon as she gets to the Pokedex reveal, we can start freaking out about the Pokedex reveal.
Oh my god, why is that at the Pokedex?
I
won't be able to hear anything, but I'll be able to see everything.
But will
That's
we hear
good
you?
Enough,
will,
right?
Will we hear
you? You don't need to hear
Oh yeah.
Me.
Okay.
Okay, send me a link. Do it. I dare you, do it.
I did, I thought. Are we
no.
on a different,
Yeah, I accidentally created two conversation windows. My bad. So while that goes on, I'll entertain everyone. On the table, we have those kind of discussions. And also, we will be hearing an exclusive, I don't think I'm going to make a whole extra video out of it, but we will be hearing a very exclusive sad story from Voltage. These are very rare occurrences that we get to hear these, and they're always quite the ride. High Voltage has plenty of sad stories to share with us, and they are very entertaining and enlightening. High Voltage, have you decided what sad story you're going to be presenting to us today?
I mean, we can pick. I can do two or one. Do you want to hear
about one so we can milk you for longer?
All right. Otherwise, I've actually been recording with sad music and everything, pics and everything for your channel, the FullRestore channel, on sad, touching stories, just as a fact of showing people that, Pokemon really isn't just a game. And hopefully Nintendo can see this too, that
unless they're giving up on that with the new Pokedex reveal, just crashing all of our theories about language and Pokemon minds. And
dude, I'm hoping
they say
electric...
that it can commute, they say that it can translate Pokemon speech for you,
dude. I'm just hoping.
what would Pokemon be saying? Would they just be saying stupid
They'll be
shit?
Screaming.
Would they just
don't
be
put me in the
shit?
Fucking ball?
or like. Like, is it going to undermine all the intelligence that we've been building up? It's going to just destroy so many theories.
Pat, why don't you evolve me, you asshole? You never even feed me. All you feed me are poffins. I need nourishment. Tauros meat or something.
Oh my god, such good trash. I'm the secretary and PR.
Hope it's
electric for the Pokemon League up there.
Okay.
That's really
I think I've got the video up. I don't know if it's the right one. I did ask you, but you ignored me.
It should say Pokemon Sun and Moon trailer.
Sorry, I've been
It doesn't have trailer in the name. Okay.
Oh, yeah. Well, now announcing Pokemon Sun and Moon. So yeah.
Okay. Three. Oh, wait. Tell me when you want me to stop.
Go.
Oh, you can start whenever.
Yeah, you're in the background.
Okay. Gotta catch them all. Okay, I have a legendary Pokemon.
Well, we can do on this podcast one story just to give everyone.
Should we do the Shedinja one or the Trap Inch one?
So Galileo is basically a lion.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Let's start with your theories about the legendaries. So the region is the Alola region, and it is. Am I too loud?
GG.
It is the Alola region, and did you send her the original trailer?
No, I sent her the new one. Explore the Alola region.
The Luna one. It looks like a bat. I like it.
Day cat. Oh, fighter of the night, bat. Oh, champion of the sun.
So far, they are very, very OP. Why the hell is the health bar got little squiggles? This makes no sense to me.
Wait,
why?
Squiggles in the health bar?
No, where the health bar for the Pokemon is, it has blue squiggles for no reason. Is this just for really weird aesthetics?
That's probably its XP. What experience the Pokemon's at?
Oh my god, this fully realized region.
The girl's hat looks like the
it's Rowlet,
penguin from.
Not Rowlet. It's a chicken hat. It's a chicken hat.
It looks like the penguin from what was it? Wallace and Gromit when he needed pants.
Oh yeah.
Actually, she kind of reminds me of, you know how you could pick your skin in this one?
Yes, and they all look like different character kind of, attitudes. Which makes me think that... I think that we're not actually getting character customization. People said that, it's confirmed that there's character customization because we saw different colored shorts on the guy. But no, I think that's just different style from the different trainer models. I think it's 8 different trainer models, and they all have a different style to them.
Oh my god, the Pokedex's name is the Malia Malia.
The what?
I haven't seen the next trailer. I haven't seen the Pokedex yet. I'm waiting at that. That's the only video I can find. I'm sorry.
That was the right video. Is it over?
Yeah, there wasn't anything interesting.
Alright, give
make sure you send her
Pokemon.
The one.
I'll find it.
Yeah, I think you just sent her the one with legendaries. So you have seen the new starters, right?
It's one is a fat owl, the other is an adorable seal, and the other is an emo cat.
Okay, well, we know who
I love getting
she's
people
picking.
Who don't follow news intensively and aren't huge, gigantic freaks about Pokemon like we are, Voltage.
Oh my god, by
you're
the way.
Fucking,
for
you
the
have a contact in Hawaii telling you
about
that's
the fucking one I
watched. Lore and shit, and then we have someone over here
I like the lion. I like the seal. I'm actually really happy she likes the seal.
Everyone's shitting on the seal, and I'm like, fuck
I'm not.
You.
I love the seal. Adorable. Wait till you hear what the leaked typing is so far.
Okay.
Holy shit. One second. I've just seen them evolving. Now I'm looking at all the videos on the side, and I'm looking at what they might look like if they evolve.
That's all fake.
I don't care. It's cool.
Okay, so you've been teasing me. What the fuck are these typings? Come on. We have insider info. That's the title of this podcast, insider info.
The owl so far is just going to be grass flying. Popplio is... Now, when I told someone about this, they got pissed because they were like, dear God, please don't...
Is it going to be water fighting?
However, I told them to shut it right away because there's only one Pokemon other than Popplio at this point that will have this typing, and it's actually a really good typing. Popplio will become a water fighting type.
Yeah.
And I predict him to be more of a circus walrus clown thing being a fighting type.
It could be a strong one.
That's the thing, is that a strongman is considered a circus act as the clown.
Are they trying to make HM whores out of your starters? Your starters so versatile that you won't need HM slaves? Because, like, a strongman would maybe, have so many however, HM moves.
Did you pick Litten?
Okay, what's Litten's types?
Well, I guess I think he might be a fire or something. I don't know. No, for maybe not.
For people who picked Litten, I am so sorry, but as it stands right now until they fully confirm it,
just
the leaks and the hack on the Pokemon page are telling everyone Litten will become a fire ground type.
What?
Yeah.
That's what you get, emo kitty.
The thing is that that literally destroys the fire starter on the fact that the water starter will dominate. On the fact that if it's a water fighting type, it will probably learn Ice Punch, which can destroy Rowlet at that point.
Well, I mean, starters always get ice moves.
That's the thing. And the other thing is Litten.
Fire ground?
I know.
What does a tiger do with digging? Like,
it's a tiger?
It's fire zodiac.
Every fire starter is a zodiac.
And every grass starter is based on evolution of life.
That makes sense
Earth.
For the Leo.
And
though,
every
actually.
Single water type is an amphibian.
Well,
explain.
Land water
type. Yeah. Explain your how you discovered this hack.
Just to
give us some sources here.
I just literally watched a bunch of people say we found out the typing, and the thing is that there was a bunch of people who literally captured their computer, went to the Pokemon page, found the images for the typings, downloaded all the typing images onto their Linux, Windows XP, whatever they were using, and the thing is that every single image they posted was like grass flying, fire type, and then fire ground, and then Popplio was like water, and then, you know, water fighting was the next thing. And they couldn't download Solgaleo and Lunala.
Okay. Now that they have been released, I can finally say
what
this.
What the
fuck? I fucking Solgaleo. Called
You were
Psychic
supposed
Steel.
To be a fire type.
Psychic Steel. I called it. I absolutely called it in the last podcast. Laura sucked my dick. I fucking called it. Everyone laughed
so
at me.
Stupid.
Psychic Steel? Why would it be Steel? Why would it be Psychic? Psychic Steel. I called it.
I'll give you this on Psychic. Psychic,
I called
yeah,
Steel.
Whatever.
I was like,
Cosmoak and Galaxies, everything.
We were talking about Palkia and Dialga, and I was like, Palkia and Dialga. Pretty weird typing, huh? They could do that again. It's Steel. It's going to be Steel. It's going to be Psychic. It's not Fire. That'd be too obvious.
My thing is that there's actually already a legendary about the moon, and there's already a legendary, or not even a legendary, there's already a Pokemon about the sun. That was the confusing part
about
sun and moon.
So tell me about your
thing.
Research into the topic.
Which one? The starters or?
No, on the sun.
Oh, yeah. So this is the confirmed thing. This isn't like waiting on Pokemon to announce Popplio and Litten's
thing from the beginning.
Okay, so Solgaleo is the Greek mythology Leo of the constellation, and Leo actually resembles the sun.
Because the constellation's in their face holes.
Yes. And Lunala is actually a Hawaiian god. Basically, the story is roughly the story is there's a kid and like something died and they want to go to heaven, and on the moon an owl comes down, and the bat comes down, and the bat's name is like Luna, and Luna takes the boy or the girl, I don't remember which one it is roughly, but brings him or her to the moon to be in heaven with their family. However, the third one, the one my cousin told me about, and oh my god, I'm so calling it right now, especially since Pokemon loves to ride the other dick of another amazing franchise from the 90s. One of the most important gods.
Are we actually getting Egyptian god Pokemon? was our prediction actually true? Are they ripping off Yu-Gi-Oh now?
That'll be next generation. Okay. Hashtag Firehorse. Ponyta will be a starter. So, oh my god, that is an amazing artwork. You should also look at the artwork for Solgaleo talking to Entei. Entei says, "Father," and Solgaleo goes, "No, I'm not your father. I'm your son."
Oh, I remember that. It's S-U-N. All right, that's the pun.
I'm just posting a thought.
So, the other god that is a Hawaiian god. God, I love you, Pokemon, for just constantly riding that dick of DBZ.
Oh.
Lord Kamehameha is a god, and also the Dawnbreaker.
Kamehameha was a king in Polynesia.
That's the thing is that in Hawaii, he's the god that can comes out of the ocean and literally destroys the dawn. That's why Goku's Kamehameha wave is always, you know, bluish, because you never know if it's the break of dawn or whatever.
Oh, yes, the Dawnbreaker.
Dawn
Pokemon.
Or dusk. Yeah, basically, my theory is it'll be a Pokemon that literally can halt time right at its core.
Well, not time as in Dialga time, but as in rotation of the Earth, kind of like air, weather, time.
You just straight up like
a horizon Pokemon, an eternal horizon.
Yeah, the Dawnbreaker or the Dusk Destroyer Pokemon, but it'll be Kamehameha, and the reason my theory is because, oh my god, does Pokemon love to ride DBZ.
Yes, but how would you turn Kamehameha into a Pokemon design?
I don't know, make King AZ a Pokemon.
Like what symbol would they have for that? How do you make the dawn into a Pokemon? Wait. In the release trailer, in the announcement trailer, you remember the thing behind the legendaries?
Yeah.
Did any of those look like the dawn or horizon?
Maybe.
We need to analyze the trailer again.
True. The thing with Kamehameha, when you can talk to... I guess this is what happens when you can talk to them.
There's already porn of them! No!
Oh yeah, porn came out within 45 minutes. Porn came out within 45 minutes, yeah.
If it goes on the internet, there's porn of it. Instant. That's rule whatever. The thing with Kamehameha is that... You look at X and Y, there's a psychic that literally says your power's over 9,000. That's a pun to Vegeta. It's over 9,000!
Well, there's also the My Body Is Ready guy. Gen 6.
There's that
so
one. Also, in Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire, the entire Rayquaza story is completely Dragon Ball Z.
Actually,
on the fact that...
Yeah, yes, the event is very Dragon Ball Z, but it's a callback to an old Playground rumor that in Emerald you would go to the moon and catch Jirachi and fight Deoxys on the surface of the moon.
That is true, but they went at it with a DBZ story. We need to go collect 7 Megastones. 7? Really? To summon Rayquaza to make my wish to destroy the meteor, which just turns Rayquaza into Shenron.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Yeah, no, that's DBZ. And then they were like, by the way, guys, you're not getting a game out of this, but look what we did to Zygarde. Okay, that's literally Cell from DBZ.
Oh, yeah.
That's literally the bad guy
Fuck
Cell.
Fuck Zygarde, because he's only 15 feet tall in that form. And what the fuck is Game Freak doing?
I found it
why
so
are they
funny
doing
when I saw that.
That are not even... Why are Game Freak making movies about things that are literally not in the games and will not have games about them?
What if the stone, the new stone in the game, activates Super Saiyan mode?
No, it's like...
I'm just saying.
I'm be surprised.
I could complain about Gen 6 for so long. Alright,
But, okay, so we got the Shenron story, we got over 9,000, we got Cell being literally Cell, And when I thought, okay, that's Zygarde perfect form, you mean like perfect cell? They were like, by the way, here's its baby form. We're calling it Zygarde cell. I'm like, you're not even hiding it anymore.
Well, I mean, they won. They got to rip off shit.
Well, yeah, but like, okay, if they're going to ride the dick of it, Hawaii literally has a god named Kamehameha. Goku's famous move.
All right.
I'm waiting on that.
I'm going to pause the recording once more just to check stuff.
Was, Rotom?
Just send her the video.
I did send her the video.
I couldn't find it in there. I guess I'm just going.
The one that introduces the girl and everything?
Yep, I showed her. I sent that one.
No, it sounded like she watched the, it sounded like she watched
the original. Yeah.
The legendary reveal.
Yeah. I saw two legendaries, yeah, and then it went to like, oh, here's different skin colors, and then it went about done there, pretty much.
I got you. Don't worry about that. Watch this. Bam!
Still
wait. Bam!
So,
is that
so,
what it looks like?
That's
I thought
your
that was a Pokemon!
That was a Pokemon.
No, that's your fucking. There's a Rotom in your Pokedex. They put a pseudo legendary Pokemon inside of your Pokedex, and it speaks English.
Going a little, making a lot of assumptions right now.
There is a Pokemon in your Pokedex that says, "Hey, bud,
that's
be
the
careful.
Reaction we wanted.
Try not to damage the goods."
What the actual fuck? No,
yes.
No. No.
You have a
fuck
Navi
you, no.
in Pokemon now, and it is a Pokemon that speaks English that
it's
is in your Pokedex.
No,
to be fair,
that.
It's not the first Pokemon to speak English.
In a Pokemon game? In game canon?
No, sure, why not?
The only other thing is Chatot.
A Pokedex inside of a Pokemon.
No,
like,
no.
English.
Aria. Rotom is a ghost electric type that infects electric appliances.
Other, like, yeah.
Okay,
it has different forms of. It has different forms of a lawnmower, a microwave, a freezer, stuff like that.
Oh,
washing
God.
Machine, fan.
I already don't like it.
No, Rotom's a favorite from Generation 4.
Yeah, he's an old one, but the fact that they're bringing
also
that back.
Also, he's an old Pokemon, like. People might not know, evidently, what a Rotom is.
And it's just like, oh my god, I'm going to try to find it, by the way.
So
I'm so pissed off about this. No, this
why?
Is no.
Why are you pissed off?
What was wrong with the old Pokedex? What was wrong with the old
one? We get a new
one?
Pokedex every region. We get a new Pokedex every region.
Yeah, but this one's stupid.
Okay, Aria, like, this will make I'm going to say something that will make it better, okay?
What?
This Pokedex allows you to browse the internet.
It okay, I'm sold.
It has Windows and applications.
All
and
the porn!
That's
in the,
not what
in
I'm
the first trailer, it shows you literally Skyping with the professor.
That is cool. Okay, I'm quite sold on that.
Like,
but
with
I
the
still
little
like
X
the
button
ones.
And shit.
Oh my god, I found it!
Well, found what?
Skype's rubbish, so.
Ready? So. They took this image down, or every place that I've been seeing, they've been trying to take this image down. These are apparently two leaked photos. I don't believe it until Pokemon or Serebii or coro-coro comes out and actually blatantly says, yes, these are real. But the fact that that Pokemon has been taking down these photos a lot and people keep reposting them, please let this be true.
Mm-hmm.
Why was, Rotom.
Just send her the video.
I did send her the video.
I couldn't find it in there. I guess I'm just going.
The one that introduces the girl and everything?
Yep, I showed her. I sent that one.
No, it sounded like she watched the it sounded like she watched
the original. Yeah.
The legendary reveal.
I saw two legendaries, yeah, and then it went to like, oh, here's different skin colors, and then it went about done there.
I got you. Don't worry about that. Watch this. Bam!
Still
wait.
Type.
Bam!
So,
is that what it looks like?
That's your Pokedex. I thought that was a Pokemon.
No, no, that's your fucking. No, there's a Rotom in your Pokedex. They put a they put a pseudo legendary Pokemon inside of your Pokedex, and it speaks English.
Going a little, making a lot of assumptions right now.
There is a Pokemon in your Pokedex that says, "Hey, bud,
that's
be
the
careful.
Reaction we wanted.
Try not to damage the goods."
What the actual fuck? No, yes. No. No.
You have a Navi in Pokemon now, and it is a Pokemon that speaks English that is in your Pokedex.
No,
to be fair,
it's
not the first Pokemon to speak English.
In a Pokemon game? In game canon?
No, sure, why not?
The only other thing is Chatot.
A Pokedex inside of a Pokemon.
No,
like,
no.
English.
Aria. Rotom is a ghost electric type that infects electric appliances.
Other, yeah.
Okay, well,
it has different forms of of a lawnmower, a microwave, a freezer, stuff like that.
Oh,
washing
God.
Machine, fan.
I already don't like it.
No, Rotom's a favorite from Generation 4.
Yeah, he's an old one, but the fact that they're bringing
also
that back...
he's an old Pokemon, like. People might not know, evidently, what a Rotom is.
And it's just like, oh my god, I'm going to try to find it, by the way.
So
I'm so pissed off about this. No, this
why?
Is no.
Why are you pissed off?
What was wrong with the old Pokedex? What was wrong with the
we
old one?
We get a new Pokedex every region. We get a new Pokedex every region.
Yeah, this one's stupid.
Okay, Aria, like, this will make I'm going to say something that will make it better, okay?
Wait.
This Pokedex allows you to browse the internet.
It okay, I'm sold.
It has Windows and applications.
All
and
the porn.
That's
in the
not what I'm
in the first trailer, it shows you literally Skyping with the professor.
That is cool. Okay, I'm quite sold on that.
Like
but
with
the
little
like
X
the
button
ones.
And shit.
Oh my god, I found it!
Found what?
Skype's rubbish, so...
Ready? So... They took this image down, or every place that I've been seeing, they've been trying to take this image down. These are apparently two leaked photos. I don't believe it until Pokemon or Serebii or coro-coro comes out and actually blatantly says, yes, these are real. But the fact that that Pokemon has been taking down these photos a lot and people keep reposting them, please let this be true. Wyatar. There we go.
It's falling. Wait, are those new Eevees?
Flying and dragon type.
What? Oh my god. It's happening.
Flying because the Alola region is going to have massive amounts of flying types, and dragon to counteract the fact that we didn't get a dragon when we got a fairy type.
Yes!
Or poison. It's either dragon or poison. One of the two, but it looks
no, it
very
better be correct. Fucking. It better be fucking dragon. Or maybe it's a dragon that does poison. You don't know.
They wouldn't
to
do two
put
times.
This image in. I need to jot down.
Well, maybe it
god.
Can learn swims. I don't fucking know. It could probably do something with poison because that would be cool. But I want it to be a dragon.
And it wow. the flying one has a dot. We're absolutely sure it's flying. I get that it's feathered, but like...
Wait, does it do a tail? Well, tails, and like spin its tails around and fly? Is that how it flies?
Yeah, are you sure it's a flying type?
Yep, that would be a flying type. Its ears are wings, and the tails...
Alright.
Basically, wait. This Pokemon, I could see it very much being
it
where
it
just soars.
And flies. Oh, okay, so it's like a squirrel.
Well, it could, flap its ears and spin its tails.
No, the flapping ears look strange. I only want spinning tails. Like, the flapping ears would make no sense to me. What the fuck is that? What you just posted?
Don't make too many visual jokes, because the audience can't see them.
I know.
Well, he's done, like, a brown little rat thing. What is that? Are these all the fake versions that...
Normion.
Normion.
Basically, that was... Yeah.
Yeah, what would it... What would the flying dragon
or the ground
be?
One I just sent you? The flying dragon. Oh, dragon? Drakeon and Sauron or Sorion.
Sorion. Huh.
Or Galeon. Or Galeon.
Galeon.
I'm so hoping, just as a little notch for me, come on, Pokemon. I fucking support you so much. I have stocks in fucking the stock market in you. Please make Litten's evolution. Name one of them Sulpur.
Sulpur.
Please. Sulpur. Please. Oh. Just for me. Do it for me.
I saw a kind of fan-made evolution of the owl, and he ended up having a wood top hat. Please make that a thing. I like that. That was cool. That
oh,
is
yeah.
Cool.
I know. The owl. I love the owl. Rowlet's going to be...
I'm stuck on this. Fireground?
Oh, you want to know the best part about Fireground? Rowlet's attacks are now neutral. And the best part is... Your ground moves don't affect Rowlet.
It gives you
a hemorrhoid. I know.
GG.
Poor fire. However, types. I mean we.
However,
have, first we have all the firefighting types. Then we have the magician.
To be fair, it's kind of Pokemon's way of saying everyone who's like hard on for the fire types. Get off the dick of the fire type. Because I know literally only three
water
out of
fighting.
Like 20. I know. Isn't that amazing? Poliwrath's the only one that's got that other than him. However, here's what I want to discuss on the best thing ever. Can we just discuss how beautiful this region actually is? Oh my god. I love it. The Alola region
is beautiful. Have you like dived into the map?
That
to
looks
try to find
amazing.
Out what's what?
Okay, so I actually figured out where we start.
Well, yes.
The top left one, not
yes,
the first island to the left, but the second one is where we start.
Yes,
that thing in the middle. Pretty sure that thing in the middle is the Elite Four.
Quite.
I could easily see it being where you have to go to island to island to island to island or port to port to port. Which, if it's ports...
But there's,
like,
there's
you know
also
how...
a giant mountain to the southwest. That could be Victory Road. There's a platform in the middle of the ocean. That could be Victory Road.
I just
Road.
Like it the fact that if you look at our first island, we got a... field, a little sand area, it looks like a tiny forest, three cities. So I'm guessing there's only one gym leader at the first one. But if I don't know where we're going to go for the second one. However, the one left to it literally has a massive,
massive
tree, a sandy island or a
tree.
Sand area, like a mountainy sand area, a volcano crater pit. Which my uncle or my cousin, who was in Hawaii, said that the hot springs there are actually
oh, dude, no,
rival
no, there's
to
a,
Japan.
There's a different island that has like tiered, dripping hot springs.
Yep,
that's gigantic. Those are huge.
Yep, and it looks like that one's in the first one I see, and then there's like a little route here and there, little grassy
yeah,
little
seem
thing.
Like there's
and
going to be a
the
lot
docks.
Of... It seems like the routes in this game are going to be very small because there's not a lot of land.
No, there's not. But
it's
I
a
mean,
lot
the
of
one
verticality,
island,
though. A lot
massive.
Of verticality.
What if you get to go on boats? That would make it a bit.
Oh yeah, well, there's
more,
that's
like,
got to be boats.
That's
yeah,
my theory. Is it
it's
boats
seeming it's
or
smaller.
Is it a more powerful surf?
Yeah, like there's, you know, we have never been able to surf on the open ocean before.
Or are we going to bring Dive back and Whirlpool?
Mm.
I'm just saying.
My
thing is, I do think there are going to be ports because every single one of these I see has like a little landing dock. I can even point to every single one. like the one right off of the first island, on the tip of the south, there's a little blue house on a little dock. And then the first one, there's these wooden docks. The third one from the right from their starting area, there's a little blue one that has a dock next to a lighthouse. And then the final one, there's another one that has like a little garden and a dock. So my thing is because every game seems to have like a little theme, like Black and White had bridges. Everything was about bridges. Bridges. There's four bridges. Everyone loves bridges. Who doesn't like a bridge?
And Gen 5 was, I mean, Gen 6 was a circle.
Well, it was gates.
Every region is gates.
Well, yeah, but this was like actually like
no,
garden
this region. Gates. This region was Lumio City. Everything connected to Lumio City.
True. But I mean, the other thing is that this one can be ports, which I'm totally fine with. I like the idea of ports because I'm actually a big fisherman and I love fishing.
7 out of 8, way
so
too much water.
I'm. Oh my god! What if they add a fourth rod? You got the old rod, the good rod, the super rod.
Please
and
don't continue that stupid experience, Cher. Undo all of the stupid stuff from Gen 6.
Introducing the Master Rod.
Dick jokes.
Yes.
Aria,
do you feel that tugging on your rod?
Aria, save us from this madness. What do you have to contribute to the podcast?
I'll splash all over your rod.
Stop. We have a minor in the podcast.
Hey, I'm not a minor.
She's not a minor over in UK.
Yeah.
I mean, over here, you'd go to jail like in a heartbeat. But over there, it's fine.
Wait. Is the
consent I'm not hitting on her. I was talking
in,
about
in
you,
England.
Pat. It's I don't want to reveal my age, but it's the my birthday coming up. That's legal age. Well, I'll be legal age doesn't mean I'm not legal age. No,
that, and I meant
in
the
process of time
rod.
That it takes me to edit these videos, she will be legal.
Probably. No, that's splash thing. That was the pad.
I'll always be jailbait.
Christ, this lolly.
There you go. Every Pokemon pedophile stream.
What?
No,
what?
Every no, they want to fuck. No, they want to fuck a Lucario.
Or I'll be there, Lucario.
Everything.
I thought that was only the fairies.
A strange amount of people want to fuck a Goodra.
I'd get sticky with that.
Jeez.
I like the idea that
shout outs to my guys, my fans, my friends in the Discord chat.
I will say this.
Which Discord?
Totally not one dedicated to Cardiff.
There's seven areas you can surf is what I'm seeing. I will say this. I love it. Love it. There's no physical way. By the way, my cousin was right. He did say that there, out of all the whole islands in Hawaii, no island is the same. And in this region, it is proving it. One's a desert, one's a forest, one's volcanic,
one's volcanic. But another one has the like blacktop magma.
Yeah,
like, dripping out into the ocean,
and I love it. Oh, dude, right there! I just see it on. What is that? What is that?
Dun, 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 dun.
There's an island that's like hidden in clouds. There's a secret island.
Illuminati. No, it's like
Illuminati confirmed.
Which direction? Cardinal.
Okay, so you see the volcanic one with like the little battlefield. It's like the third right one. See that last, if you just scan a little over.
Squinting.
There's a little island trying to be hidden by a cloud.
What is their deal with clouds, man?
I like clouds.
Every generation fucking hides some shit. Ever since Generation 4. Generation 4 hid that weird-ass shit in the upper right. The battle area.
I think Generation 3 did, too. Because the Battle Frontier was...
Yeah, Battle Frontier. Yep.
I do see the fact, I see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 boats, so I'm positive we move from island to island on boats.
Also, someone was freaking out about how the map is GPS. Like, it's actual visuals and not a depiction.
What if this is the game we wanted, and the fact that these boats can lead to other generations?
No, stop. We're in the middle of the Pacific. We're nowhere near any other region.
Nah, not with that attitude.
We have boats, so can't we travel anywhere?
Yeah,
we can,
right?
Travel the world.
What if that big, massive fucking middle island that's like the Pokemon League, what if that actually just turns into a giant-ass boat?
Dude, don't give me Pokemon Ranger team signs or whatever they're called, flashbacks. That plot
went
from 0 to 60 with the fucking golden armor that makes you immortal.
Oh my god, I would love to visit Aura region or the Fiora region or the Omnia region or Oblivia. Sorry, those are the Pokemon Ranger ones.
Good games.
However, fun fact, Omnia, Pokemon Ranger, whatever the one was in Omnia, fun fact, is the only region to not have an O in it.
Huh. Okay.
Otherwise, every other region has an O. Actually, is like that's like their thing. By the way, I'm going to throw a red card off topic.
This is a red card podcast.
Holy shit. I went everywhere, balls to the walls, to find that Manaphy pin today.
Oh my god, you and the pins.
I have all of them. I have every single one of them, and the Manaphy one, I literally had to drive an extra, like, hour around Minnesota to find this fucking pin. Toys R Us didn't have it. 3 GameStops didn't have it. Target didn't have it. They have an abundance of Mew still, and Celebi. No Jirachis. They're gone.
What the fuck is that little palm tree island?
Which one?
The one in the upper right, behind the cloud. It's just got, like, one tree. It's like the one from Super Mario Sunshine.
That's
where... Oh, sorry, you gave me flashbacks of my game.
Oh, my god. Good chills. By the way, I love the fact that the professor is Professor Kui Kui, and the tree that is, like, Hawaii's palm tree is actually called the Kui Kui tree.
Yes. I mean, they're always named after trees. Except the one time they made a girl professor.
No, Sycamore's the tree.
Yeah, no. the one time they made a female professor, they named her after a bush.
Oh, no, Juniper.
They named her after a bush.
A bush. A bush.
Oh, I mean, tree,
oh my
tree,
god,
bush.
No!
I mean,
you're joking, right? You're joking.
Oh my god, it's because girls have bush and dudes have hardwood. Ha! Love it. Pokemon, you are fucking awful. You're a horrible game.
FullRestore After Dark.
I can't wait to buy the new game. It's best game ever. 10 out of 10. Wood bang.
Whoa.
Best game ever. 10 out of 10. 10 out of
10. 10 out of 10. Best game ever. 10 out of 10.
10 out of
10. 10 out of 10.
All right, I think it's time for a break with Sad Stories from Voltage. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do
transition I've ever heard in my life. All right.
Rainbow effect. Aria, rainbow
you can
effect.
Pick, do you want to hear a sad story about two best friends or brothers?
Best friends, because who cares about brothers?
Wow.
I don't have a brother. I have a sister. Screw
I do. I do, but he's a dick.
We now take you to Sad Stories with Voltage. The story of which Pokemon?
It's Absol.
Oh, the Absol one. I thought you were going to do the Shininja.
Aria, grab a tissue. No, that was the brothers. Aria,
tissues. I'm a man.
And if you're a man, then you'll want to grab a tissue.
Then you'll want to grab a towel.
Because fap jokes.
What?
Those, fap they're fap. there's two boys.
Okay.
Or there's one boy.
Let's get the mellow
to
music.
To a new location.
Hold up. If you have... Oh, do some God. Voice acting for this. In a world.
Voice acting.
Okay.
In a world filled with sad stories.
Two boys. Two brothers. Best friends. Or best friends. Yeah, best friends.
Oh, my God. No.
Would you like to come in for some candy, children?
Making my way downtown with my bitch. She's gonna make me a sandwich.
And then she hits me.
That's not how the song goes.
And I cry. And we're getting a divorce.
Oh, look, that's a sad story within itself.
Right. All right. So what the story goes, there's a boy who moves to a new town, completely brand new. It's around middle school year. He hasn't made a lot of friends at all. He's been struggling, and he's actually scared to go out of the house, but his mother makes him go out of the house one day. And what happens is he runs into a boy, and the boy says, "Hey, you should get out your Pokemon game. We should have a battle." This boy is very friendly. The new kid on the block actually says, I've never played Pokemon in my life. And the kid goes, "What? Do you need a Pokemon game?" He's like, "Well, what do you play it on?" And he says, "A Game Boy Advance." And he goes, "I don't even have that." And the kid in the neighborhood says, "Hold on a second." Runs to his house, comes back, gives him a Game Boy Advance and a copy of Sapphire. The two become friends and start playing Pokemon for a while. And every day they battle, they trade, and they like to tell each other the progress that they've made. Well, eventually Diamond and Pearl come out, but they don't really move on to the next game. They more or less like to keep the nostalgia of third gen. Now, the one boy moved away for college at this point, and the other boy also moved away from this town. So neither of them are in their own town anymore. They went their separate ways for colleges. They still kept in contact, though. And the one guy, or the hometown kid, calls up the new kid and says, "Dude, I finally did it. I can't believe I actually did it. I caught my favorite Pokemon. A shiny Absol, adamant nature. It's amazing." And the other kid says, "There's no way you caught that." Sends him a little phone snap photo of it. Blown away. A few years go by, and HeartGold comes out, and the new Pokemon games are coming out. Black and White is around this time, and the one boy calls, or the hometown boy calls up the new kid and says, "Hey, how have you been?" And he sounds different. And the new kid says, "I'm pretty good. I've managed to, you know, establish myself. I'm doing pretty good in college." And the hometown kid says, "Yeah, things have been pretty rough with me." The new kid says, "What do you mean?" "I've actually been diagnosed with cancer," the hometown kid says. The hometown kid then says, "Can you come out and meet me?" This is during Black and White time, and that is crucial to the story, because as the new kid goes to see his buddy, who is dying in the hospital actually at this point, The little final bit of words that the two say to each other is, "I want you to have my copy of Ruby. It's got the shiny Absol in it."
It was Sapphire.
No, he gave Sapphire to the new kid.
Oh,
Ruby was the one he had. So he goes, "Ruby, here's my Ruby copy. It's got, you know, it's got the shiny adamant nature Absol." And at that point, the one kid says, "I can't take it." And he says, "Please, it'll be as if I never left." Eventually, some time goes on, and the hometown kid does pass away. The new kid is absolutely crushed by this. And around this time, they announce X and Y. And he goes, "Okay, I need to transfer this Pokemon to X, or I'm going to transfer this Pokemon. So, because he heard about me and that you can play with it. What he didn't know was the Mega Evolution. And someone said, have you had Absol's Mega Evolution yet? One of his college buddies randomly says it to him. And he goes, no. He's like, okay, well, you go get the Absolite here. And he goes and gets it. And then uses it one time. The story ends with him bawling his eyes out as he sees his buddy's shiny Absol Mega Evolve. And the fact that this Pokemon is supposed to resemble him, or his friend that passed away, he sees Absol with angel wings.
And thus concludes Sad Stories with Voltage, Episode 1. It's a long comment.
I told you.
It's the angel wings that thing was, is like...
It's a long time in the making, but the fact that the one dude's buddy died of cancer...
Well, I mean, there's a secondary part to the story. Absol is said culturally that whenever it appears,
a disaster
is to follow. They
ironic
find the
that they
Absol,
gave it angel.
And then he gets cancer. And in each analysis, like in the manga, you see that it's not the Absol caused disasters. It's the Absol are trying to help people with the disasters.
Prevent the disaster.
Yeah.
But the fact that it got angel wings was the fact that he was just...
But, like, it's also, like, they find the Absol, and then he gets cancer because disasters come with Absols. That's like, oh, my God.
The one is actually, like, Jesus, that's... He's actually one of the best double-team players out there. But that'll be for another day, because you got to milk this pit dry.
And thus we move on from set. Arya, your response?
I already did my response. It was a whimper.
Then can we have freaked out Lolly response?
To what?
Oh my god. I'm so sad. No?
I'm heartless. I don't get sad.
Oh, you could put on a character and
show people.
I'm sitting, like, it was a good. Story.
I'm not like moved either because like I'm a sociopath. So, like.
Right. Hashtag psycho friends.
I am not psycho. I was just enjoying the story. I'm not affected by death. It's weird.
I only empathize with characters. Now that we've all shown how insane we are, how do we move on from a story about dead children?
How about the fact that I'm going to walk into traffic because I can't fucking beat Krogonk on Pokemon Shuffle?
Rip.
It's not even rip, just fuck this game.
You need to pay more money.
It's literally a pay-to-win bejeweled fucking game.
Well, how about you put the game down and do drugs instead?
I can't, because here's the thing about the game. You can only play 5 rounds at a time, and then you have to wait like 2.5 hours to get your 5 of your hearts back, which you can only have a max of. And you have to spend hearts to play the game. Here's how they get you, because it's free. Unless you go online... Buy some jewels with real money, spend jewels to get hearts so that you can keep playing.
That's what they always do. That's been around for ages.
It's called pay to wins.
All right, so did we have any other Pokemon
got
topics?
A fucking genre.
Yeah. So let's talk about the next topic.
A Krogonk and punch it in the face?
One of the last topics here, okay? Fucking Rotom that talks. And how this... Let's do a versus seeker segment. How this breaks all of the theories. That
I'm just stoked for the fact that Bad Dex is going to have just a hell of a day.
Okay.
I want to hear all the Pokemon screaming.
Let's go back to Generation 5, okay? We get the dream world. Why? And we get to see what Pokemon dreams look like. Okay? What?
I love that. Let's go back to Generation 5. Why?
No, but we remember the dream really world, right?
That's where I never got into it.
I did the dream world twice. And it's a good thing I did because I got a level 15 Druddigon at the beginning of the game.
I'm seriously going to fucking go catch like 18 Krogunks on my game.
And then...
not shuffle, the regular one. And then I'm just going to release them. Into the void of hell. I can't beat them.
You got to take them into the Elite Four and just watch them get wrecked.
Just fucking annihilated. I'm going to find the game where the Elite Four member is a psychic type right off the bat.
Doesn't exist.
No, well, it does. I mean, it's slope.
Oh, yeah. Second generation. Not Miles. Fuck. Will.
Is that his name?
Yes, Will.
Wow, what a memorable character. To the fact that three people who
Gen
play
Pokemon
are like, who the fuck that weirdo?
Gen 2 was
weird. Fucking weirdo.
That's strange. I have a friend named Will, and he's weird, but he's cool at the same time.
Is he a weirdo?
Well, he's like a good weirdo. That's the thing.
There's no such thing.
So, Voltage, I don't know if... Have you listened to our Versus Seeker episode? Versus Seeker is our podcast where we talk about trainer life and what it would be like in the game canon world. And we talk about how trainer classes could be a cultural phenomenon of cosplay gone awry. And how it's this big...
Oh, you're getting that.
Huh?
You're getting that in Sun and Moon.
Well, I had cosplay. I'm happy.
Yeah, the idea was that trainer classes were like a fun thing to do. And then it became very integrated in the actual culture. And then it became like a job to do. And then it basically got, you know, in Japanese fashion, people took it way too seriously and it became giant. And, you know, people actually started taking it really seriously. And people who, you know, X years ago when it was just kind of a fad starting off, if you wanted to be a psychic trainer, you would just pretend to be psychic and cosplay and be silly and be fake, you know? But after a while, and after those kind of people grew older, they started taking their hobbies more seriously and started to actually do research, you know? It's the idea of, you know, the difference between a 12-year-old playing Dungeons & Dragons and a 23-year-old playing Dungeons & Dragons. One's going to do their actual research. And, you know, so if a psychic trainer grows up and takes their thing more seriously, they're going to actually learn psychic strategies and learn how to levitate Pokeballs. And, you know, a ghost trainer is going to start channeling and a macho man's actually going to build up strength and everything. And after long enough, they're going to go fucking insane. You know, like the trainer class cosplay is just going to turn them into raving otakus that are just blindly insane for Pokemon battling. And that's, I think, what the world that we see. And that's what we talk about in the first Versus Seeker episode. So in this, we're going to talk about how a Rotom speaks English and nobody freaks out. What?
What?
What? What is our favorite color?
How does nobody freak out? How is this not revolutionary?
Because people are dumb.
I will get to that in a minute. I have a massive erection right now because I just beat the Krogunk. I've been stuck on that prick for 2 days, so pretty stoked about
Set
that.
It down.
However, I don't think anyone really gets too like, oh my god, about that because in X and Y they kind of introduced the fact that they're like multi-languages, and they're like, hey, this guy's from France, and it's like, well, what does he say?
No, it's not that it's English. It's that you can understand this Pokemon speaking, and nobody freaks out.
I told you, it's because people, it's dumb. They will, like, freak out over this one small thing, and then a big thing happens, they're like, meh. It's how people are.
How is the professor saying, oh yeah, there's a Rotom in your Pokedex, it's cute. And not like, you can ask a Pokemon what evolution is?
Well, number one, I'm pretty sure that Pokemon professor needs to contact, like, six other professors.
Or I think I know what it could be. Keep in mind, this is the Mega Evolution world, where we have access to fucking infinite energy and access to different universes.
Mm-mm. Maybe it's not the Mega Evolution world. It's a multiverse right now.
Yes, but I think maybe this is in the same multiverse, in the same universe as X and Y and Auras.
Maybe the professor isn't freaking out because he's been around this for a lot longer than we think.
True, true. But I think the idea is that I think this human race in this world is transient and kind of not fazed by any technological discovery because they live in a utopia with infinite energy. They can do anything they want. It's basically Star Trek. They can probably materialize food if they want to. They have teleporting. They have the link cable. They have space lasers that can destroy meteors. I think that's why they aren't fazed by anything. I think it's a comparison to the real world where we're in such a postmodern world that, you know, here's what I said in one of my recent videos. The future doesn't come and we feel it. The future comes so slowly and we feel it coming on that we never really react. 4 years ago, I see a news story on Yahoo about how they have a working prototype for a flying car. It's a car that drives and that peels down wings and that takes off. And nobody gives a shit because it's not a commercially available product. But then, if that became commercially available today, nobody would give a shit because they would be like, yeah, we knew that you could do that. It's just kind of lame. You know? We expect, and if someone says that, like, this exists or whatever, we say, well, yeah, I expected that we could do that.
Here's a perfect example. You know, with the, adding on to the example, you can pay for your phone now. Well, now, someone's actually been able to put a chip in their hand, scan their hand, and they can pay with their hand, just swiping it.
Yeah, and nobody bats an eye because we assume that we could do that already.
I told my mom this, and she was like, oh, what?
Yeah, older people,
it's just
yes.
It's a generation.
Older people, yes, and people who live in less developed areas, yes. But now imagine that we live in that you go to a very modern, scientifically advanced region with probably, you know, near nuclear ships running off of infinite energy, driving from island to island, and people would just kind of be living in this surrealism of, like, because the Pokemon world is so perfect, except for, like, it's so perfect that, you know, one single mob appears and that's the worst thing that's going on. Like, in the Pokemon world, you have Pokemon that help you solve any problem. If you want to move, Pokemon will help you move. If you want company, Pokemon will give you company. If you want to become stronger, Pokemon will make you stronger. Pokemon are the answer to all of your problems. So we're just, like, living in this world of just, like Star Trek, where nobody's really fazed about day-to-day life or scientific discovery.
I want to know more about the Pokemon War.
I want, like, every region, the scientist has had the thing they focus on. Generation 1, it was the Pokedex. Generation 2, it was breeding. 3, it was... what the fuck did Rowan do?
He
did nothing.
Different forms of evolution. Why do certain Pokemon evolve in different areas or different ways?
Okay. Rowan was evolution. Again, apparently. And then Juniper
a lot of them are
evolutions. And then this new one. Maybe we just haven't seen it from this trailer, but maybe his focus is on Pokemon speech.
Communication.
Yeah.
I don't believe so.
Well, what
would
that
make sense
be?
Why we suddenly are seeing like
Sycamore,
Skype.
Sorry, I skipped Sycamore. Sycamore was fairy types
evolution.
And mega evolution.
Megas.
But it
this
was
one,
also very
okay,
specifically
so.
Fairy types because those two superhero kids are his assistants, I think.
Yep.
Yeah.
They are.
So it was fairy types
I'm
and mega
show-
evolution.
I am going to take a photo of one thing, and I'll show you why. What the professor's focus will be on. Well, it's in the Rotom pick.
Oh, okay. What is it? I can edit in the photo.
So the main focus will be that stone.
The orange stone thing?
That stone could be one of two stones. It can also be three. However, the third is kind of unlikely.
Since apparently they don't do sister games now.
It can either be off of a manga from 5th gen, that's the one I'm hoping this doesn't happen. And this relates to your Versus Seeker talk on cosplay. With that little bait in mind, the other thing the stone could be is off of a game that's already out that's done ridiculously well before Sun and Moon were ever even conceived of. And it could easily be that as well. Which,
well,
that one,
I
hope it is.
We're recording, so go.
Okay, so what it could be off of the manga is a Burst Heart stone. Burst Heart? Have you ever seen the fourth season of Digimon?
Are you talking about Pokemon Reburst?
I'm talking about where you fuse
wait,
with your Pokemon.
Are we talking about Ash Greninja? Fuck!
Yep.
No!
Cosplaying as you combining with your Pokemon. It could be that, which is awful and a stupid, dumb fucking idea.
Well, I mean, people who are fans of the
anime...
I mean, we did an anime episode, and since then, the anime has gone from 0 to 60, and the animation quality is insanely good. The writing is... People are praising it.
But anime is never canon.
I know. Well, here's the fucking thing. They're doing shit that doesn't affect the games and only affects the anime now. They're announcing Zygarde and all his forms without those forms ever being available at all in X and Y.
The fact that Ash Greninja is in the show.
Yeah, and people are like,
but
he's
Ash
doing
Greninja,
really well.
But they say Ash Greninja is once in every 1,000 years that this has happened. So that's kind of the little breakaway part on that.
True, but the anime doesn't have infinite energy and access to the multiverse.
No. But one thing is that Burst Heart is, if you do fuse with your Pokemon and your Pokemon is knocked out, or if you are battling as you.
Wait, are we calling a Steven Universe on this now?
Yes, we are.
No.
Well, I mean, more of a Digimon.
It's
more of a Digimon.
It's more...
I never watched Digimon.
Okay, it's basically Power Rangers and Pokemon.
Well,
it'll be a
like
human body
animal
with Pokemon armor.
Oh.
And the thing is if you get knocked out...
Well, if we look on PokéStar Studios... We did that. In PokéStar Studios, human actors and the things that they play and prop objects have typings.
Yep.
Which
the thing
makes
is, though,
you wonder all sorts of shit. Like, maybe type advantage doesn't actually exist and it's all a game. Maybe Pokemon battles aren't actual... Maybe Pokemon battles are roleplay. Like, it's not actually what we think it is.
It's like a massive roleplay game that has gotten so big.
Bruh, what if Pokemon don't actually have types and it's all just... Bruh, what if it's all acting? Bruh.
If I showed you one image of what a Burst Heart evolution looks like...
Weed comments.
If you're...
Things you say when you're high.
I want that. I actually hope it's that. I want that. It would be so cool if it's just a massive roleplay that has gone out of hand. No, that would be so cool.
Do you want to know why that would be awful?
Yeah,
no,
why
awesome.
Would it be bad?
It makes
sense,
because they're like all kids.
Why would Burst Hearts
because
be
if you because if you fuse with your Pokemon and you get knocked out, no matter what remains on the team, you are knocked out and you are unable to battle.
So it'd be a version of Mega Evolution
it's a
where
risk
you only
call.
Have one Pokemon left in your team. It'd
it's
be
a risk
last, a last effort thing, which would make...
But what
the
if it's so good
runs.
That you start with it?
I think it would be something you'd put in the back end. But, I mean, yeah, I mean, yeah, like, here's the thing, okay? Yeah, you could just have the one Pokemon sweep the game, but people do that anyway. If it's a thing that makes the Pokemon games too easy, that doesn't really matter, because people who enjoy the games and are professionals will just not use it that way. But imagine playing a challenge run, and you're like, you're down to your two last Pokemon, you're like, all right, do I go with sending out the second to last one to bite out for a little bit longer, or do I just say, fuck it, and go with the last one, and if he loses, the run ends. And it's just like on the back, because, oh my god, okay, I told you about how my paired coma run in Oras ended, right? By the way, with my Cradily.
I don't think you told me about your Cradily. Oh wait, you did.
With Metagross. And now yep. I was down to my last Pokemon, and Metagross was really low, and I was like, come on, bro. Let's do it. And Meteor Mash missed, and Giga Drain landed, and I won, and everyone was brought back. Imagine having that feeling in a challenge run, but you have a big flashy button that you can push, and then epic music starts playing, and a cutscene happens, and you're like, let's do it! That would be pretty awesome.
I sent an image of Burst Heart Bouffalant. You tell me if you want that.
I mean, I don't want that, but...
That's what you're gonna get. Like, that is fucking dumb. It is ridiculously stupid. It actually killed Digimon for, like, literally 5 seasons.
I mean, but it seems to be working in the anime.
Mm-mm. It works with Greninja.
In the anime, Ash isn't cosplaying.
No, but if Greninja gets knocked out...
Yeah, I like that. Because here's my opinion on that. People who play Pokemon games don't white out enough.
This is true. But my thing is...
People go through Pokemon games and never white out.
My thing is, I would like it to be the second option. I would love for the second option.
Okay,
like,
tell us.
The second option is from Pokeken.
Pokeken Tournament with the
Synergy Stones.
Synergy. That's
I would love for it to be where you build
Mewtwo's
up a gauge.
Chest.
I would love it to be where you build up a gauge, hit the button, and your Pokemon goes Super
either,
Saiyan
either
Gold
Mega Evolves
for like three
or
turns.
Or goes Super Saiyan for three turns.
Yeah, it just goes...
Because Synergy Stones... Because you don't need a Mega Stone to Mega Evolve. You don't. It's just a way to channel... Because you're plebs. Because you don't have a real connection with your Pokemon. It just makes a connection from whatever is left there. But Synergy Stones, you might actually have to like build up affection and stuff and like do certain things to complete tasks to build up Synergy.
Your friendship has to be like 60 or above and at the
same
time...
Yeah, it could be like a better version of Mega Evolution. And you wouldn't need an item slot. You would have an open item slot. Oh my god. What if when you use Synergy, the Pokemon choose its own moves, like in Generation 3 they were supposed to? Like Battle Tense? What if you use the Synergy and then the Pokemon acts on its own?
See, the reason I
what
think
if they
that...
Put they put Amiibo technology into all of your Pokemon so that when they go Synergy, they use moves that you've trained them to use? They have the technology.
Are you making Amiibo cards for Pokeken?
No. I mean, like, in the mainline Pokemon game, and they use the technology from Amiibos to track how you use your Pokemon in battles, and then when you use Synergy, it fights the way it has learned to fight from what you have done with it. So if you spam Water Gun, it will spam Water Gun. And if you use status moves, it will use status moves. Dude.
Question for
you. You're blowing my mind.
Have you ever watched Full Metal Alchemist?
A little tiny bit.
Yes. Yes.
You like that?
Mm.
Can I show you why I don't want I don't want fusion? That's why I don't want fusion.
Wait! No! No!
Hi, Mom.
That's why I don't want fusion.
Chimeras.
No!
Woof.
No, basically, can I explain this to Patt, seeing he doesn't understand?
I think I knew what it was. It's a chimera, right?
Wait, are you talking... The only fusion that straightway comes to mind is the one with the bird and human-y thing.
The bird and the human-y
thing? That's like... Yeah, it's like really near the beginning, where he's trying to bring back the boyfriend of this girl, and it turns into like a bird human-y thing.
Oh, yeah. That wasn't just the original Alchemist. That wasn't in Brotherhood.
Oh, I don't care. I'm going to the original.
Either way,
so
they're both...
like that, right?
I mean, I'd be down basically, for a bit of horror in my
imagine...
Pokemon games.
No. Imagine we'll have mixing a dead lump of meat with birds and trying to bring it back to life.
Yeah, that doesn't end well. Oh, hey, yeah. If that, you're a Fullmetal Alchemist fan, have you seen Game Theory's video on it?
Yeah,
or Film Theory's video on it? What's your opinion of that?
On that. I think it's perfect because that just kind of throws a wrench in the whole plot. I'll send her the link for that.
Yeah, but the thesis of the video I'm referencing, hold up. The thesis of the video I'm referencing, Arya, is that that recipe that he cycles through the whole anime that you haven't watched because you didn't watch Brotherhood is slightly wrong in its calculations, and that explains every single thing wrong with the creature they make when they try to resurrect their mom. It's fine.
Basically, they just got the formula wrong.
The only reason I haven't watched Brotherhood is because I was going to watch it with a person, and then
actually,
I'm waiting for them to come back.
Brotherhood? Now, I'm not a fan. I'm normally a harsh critic on it. They're both the best anime I've ever watched, ever. However, I will say this. That one was flawless. I love it. It was perfect. Both of them are great. You can't go wrong by picking either one. I prefer Brotherhood just because the ending is better.
I haven't seen yet. The thing is, it's just a good anime. They even got the bloody English like dub right. Like even people are saying the English dub was actually good for once, and it's just a good anime. It's good.
Actually, you want to know something interesting about Pokemon and Fullmetal Alchemist?
Shoot. What?
The guy who plays Elric for the voice actor is actually Keldeo in the Pokemon movie.
Japanese or English?
English.
Oh!
The English one is Keldeo in the Pokemon movie.
Oh, that's cool.
But, Patt, that photo of Arcanine, basically, the episode was this dude is a state alchemist because he got a chimera to talk. But his wife died recently, and the family dog got sick after that, too. And his alchemy exam was coming up. Otherwise, they were going to take away all his money and his thing. And he made another talking chimera, and his daughter and dog went missing around the exact same time.
Uh-oh.
Basically, he figured out how
to fuse... I know
this
story.
Yeah, he basically figured out how to fuse humans with animals to make a talking chimera. That's that whole photo. The trainer is basically his daughter, who is five, with his dog.
Right, yeah.
It's sick and twisted. That's why I don't want Pokemon fusion, because that's just... it's
yeah, best
no,
father ever.
I don't
ever.
Want to fuse with my Pokemon.
I mean...
Yeah, best
father.
Yeah.
Father ever.
I mean,
to be fair, he's better than Pokemon father.
Oh, wait, he was never there.
Yeah, you don't even get one of them. Well, you do in third gen. And he still doesn't care about you.
Oh my god, the manga.
I love it. I love Ruby's Nuzlocke about the little comic Ruby made. It's like, go good, Ruby. He sends out like slacking, and that's good, Ruby. He doesn't care about his son.
And he's grown up beside it his whole life.
I love it.
Yeah.
I love that your dad in third gen hates you. I love it that the only dad you get in the game just doesn't want to even
live
in the same
house.
Have
you read Pokemon Adventures?
I've read all of it.
Okay. Arya, are you looking for a manga to read?
Maybe.
Pokemon Adventures till third gen.
No, till fourth gen.
Aw, it's not good in fourth gen.
Hey, it's better than fifth gen. And you got to read it for the culmination at the end of Heart Gold Soul Silver. That is the reading end of the story.
Reading a rock is better than fifth gen.
Yeah, fifth gen is rough. But you got to finish it.
Back to my Noragami.
Aria, put down in your notes to read Pokemon Adventures from Generation 1 to Generation 4.
After I finish Noragami, okay. And then I will.
Fucking, without spoiling it, the reason why your dad does what he does in Ruby and Sapphire in the manga.
Mm.
High voltage.
It does work.
And
I was Wally, for my
Wally, when Wally is bleep on bleep.
Wally is straight up my favorite character.
And when Wally realizes that Norman wanted, yeah. Children,
oh my god, Patt, I have a theory about Wally.
Wally!
Oh my god, what color is Wally's hair?
Oh no, yeah, Wally's a Sutopolitan.
No, what color is his hair?
White?
Wally? No, it's green.
Yeah, it's green. Greenish white. Green.
Want me to blow your mind?
What?
What color is N's hair?
Greenish.
What is N's full secret background story?
Harmonia was in a forest and he talked with animals and Getsus took him?
No. Basically, there was a boy who could learn how to talk with animals, and at the same time, though, the boy died, and the background story of N is that he's a Zororark, because the Zorora that he talked to evolved and took the form as him. N is a Zororark.
Yeah.
You want to know something about Wally?
What?
Wally's got asthma.
He actually died?
Wally is N.
Alright.
The first Pokemon he got was a Ralts. Ralts help talk and synergy with you because they can feel emotions and feelings and aura.
Hey man, don't bring up sad Ralts in Gardevoir. I can't handle.
I know, but isn't that
also from this Gardevoir community that I'm in? There's a giant conspiracy about Gardevoir and the gender ratio. And how?
Oh yeah, no.
And
Gardevoir's
how Gardevoir was supposed
male.
To actually be a 90-10 gender ratio thing. Like it wasn't supposed to be 50-50.
Because
Gallade was supposed to be in that generation.
Basically, the thing is that Ralts actually resemble or Gardevoir actually resembles a knight without armor. Which is the reason why the class of that is, it's supposed to be a male, because knights used to be males only.
No, there was very few. The female. Conspiracy theory is that the gender ratio used to be, because the gender ratio right now is higher on female.
Well, yeah, now it is.
They changed that. The conspiracy theory is that was always supposed to be the case, but they never got around doing it. And this whole thing about male Gardevoirs being equally, that was not supposed to be the case. That's their whole theory.
I do want to throw one thing in. I'm going to throw in a plug. I don't ever do this usually. People who even know what my channel is, I do a series
just
called
just
Bad
a review
Dance.
About his channel. He is the reason why this channel exists. So listen to what he has to say.
Basically, a little plug for Bad Dex. Number 3 came out recently, and it's Helioptile. It wouldn't give me Cinemax. I'm just going to let everyone know. Be prepared for... I have 5 episodes recorded. After 3. Get ready for a Gligar episode.
Right up your alley.
Get ready for a Clang episode.
Ooh.
And my god, does Bad Dex not appreciate Clang at the fact that it's literally just a gear. A Shelgon where don't poke at the dragon. We have an episode where Bad Dex has. We find out that Bad Dex has Pokemon. He actually owns Pokemon. He has a Haunttail.
Ooh.
And doesn't matter. Doesn't matter who it is. Bad Dex does not care who it is, especially when it's Moltres. So the fifth episode that's going to be coming out will be a legendary. We're going to take on our first legendary.
Okay, so you, I mean, like, I have to, I actually already advertised the third episode in the New York City trip video.
Aww.
And I also, why don't you, I also, you should really
that's
watch that because
it.
I totally don't threaten you that why you haven't had me in an episode of Bad Dex yet.
When is it? more towards July or August, I will have hopefully a new microphone, but I would love to do a recording of where Bad Dex goes and grabs the Pokedex, and he forgot to put batteries in it, so he has to call upon the Hoenn Pokedex.
Yeah, buddy!
I'm just waiting for the fact that I can't wait for Bad Dex to do Rotom Pokedex.
Yes. Oh my god, get Arya to do it!
What is this thing?
Get Arya to do it. Get Arya to do a chibi voice for the Rotom.
Well, Rotom makes this voice. He does
because it's a ghost.
Perfect.
I ship it. Do it.
But actually, the fifth gen actually has Pokedex entries already.
Yeah.
Or not fifth gen. I'm sorry, not fifth gen. Seventh gen.
Okay. Request contact details with Arya right now. Let's make this happen.
Oh, as Rotom? Yeah, when they announce.
Wait, what am I doing?
Do you want to be a voice actor on Bad Dex?
I don't have a good microphone.
It's good enough. It's an electric ghost type that's haunting a device. It's supposed to sound staticky.
Yeah, basically, as long as you can make this voice sound very hyperactive and very fucking annoying, we're perfect.
What voice? Oh, basically Navi. Hey, listen, hey.
Perfect.
Yeah, and then like a little giggly laugh.
That's a perfect ghost laugh if I ever heard it.
As long as you have that, perfect. Because Bad Dex is, so basically what Bad Dex is, he's an alcoholic Pokedex who has a severely.
Pokedex.
No, he's a Unova.
Oh, right.
Is it in Unova? Is that what we were just? No, Kalos.
He's a Kalos Pokedex.
Yeah, he's Kalos. He's a Kalos Pokedex because I thought that that was the laziest design for a Pokedex. That's why he's the Kalos one. but basically, he's got a beard, and he's got eyes, and he doesn't.
He's got
not
stubble.
Care.
He doesn't have a beard.
No, I mean, like, I seriously went and found a goatee beard and just kind of cropped and pasted over it. But basically, this Pokedex has a trainer who picked him out of a garbage can and is...
Gee
Willikers! Yeah! Pokedex is a very dumb trainer, and this... Basically, the voice
We have proof that he's not actually dumb, and that's kind of an act, because when Bad Dex does something he's not supposed to, he'll break character and just be like,
you can't say that on YouTube.
Or like the new one, I found the key to the medicine cabinet. What's that? It's where you hide all the booze. Pokedex, I don't have any booze. What the fuck am I drinking? It's mouthwash. Still got the job done. Yeah, basically the three episodes I have up right now are Persian, Frillish, and Helioptile. Or not Helioptile, Heliodisc. And basically Persian is the first step episode, he pees in Bad Dex's shoes, and so he wants to skin the kitty. And then Frillish is, what the, no, none of this kawaii, cutesy, one's blue, one's pink, so everything's kawaii, senpai, I don't want any of this crap. And then he's like, okay, so this thing's a water ghost. Holy shit, this thing's a ghost type?
Yeah, which I used in my 5-year anniversary video for the best intro transition in that entire video of... Holy, this thing's a ghost type?
Right. And then the Helioptile is Heliodisc. Basically, this thing, Bad Dex thinks he's a satellite dish and wants Cinemax to watch porn. So he throws rocks at it. I suppose we can get people stoked for the next couple ones. Gligar, he's terrified of, because he's like, what the fuck is this thing? It's a bat scorpion? No. Get it the fuck away from me. Bad Dex, what are you doing? Bad Dex, put the bug spray down. I'm going to kill this thing.
Kill it. I fucking hate Gligar.
Well, and then the thing is that Clang, he's like, what the shit is this?
Don't spoil too much.
Well, yeah, and then Shelgon, he's like...
Shelgon's pretty funny, yeah.
He's just like, what the shit is this? He's like, Mad Dex, it's a dragon type. Don't pick on it. He's like, it's got titty legs. It's a fucking ball.
Oh, my God.
And then he's like... And then Huntail one is... He's going to come on and go, all right, so we're going to do Huntail. All right, go Huntail. Bad Dex, do you have Pokemon? Yeah. How do you get a Pokemon? What, just because you think I'm a Pokedex, I can't raise Pokemon? That weird Majin Buu ripoff thing. Mewtwo? Yeah, that one. He did it.
But he has
And homes. Then Moltres, and then Moltres is like... the kid is like... Bad Dex! It's Moltres. Oh, so now it's suddenly a special episode because the flaming chicken's on. Bad Dex is a legendary. Don't ruin this for me. Why are you getting so touchy? It's a shitty Pokemon anyways. One rock. What?
Oh, look. It's Sunday dinner.
One rock move and this thing becomes a Thanksgiving feast.
Rock.
And then, let's see. I don't have them recorded yet, but... Where is it? This note? I believe it's this note. It's not that note. Which note is it? I have notes, by the way.
Just got ignored. Okay.
I'm sorry, what was
I'm
that?
I'm sure the audience
sorry,
is was... not ignoring you.
Huh?
Keep in mind, Arya, I will have to listen to this entire thing over again, possibly
over,
twice to edit
and over.
And upload.
Oh my god.
Okay.
So much editing. I will say this, the next four after those will be sadly enough, I have to destroy one of my favorites. Not in this order, but the next four I have lined up for scripting is Cyndaquil. Pubitar.
Dude,
Metatite. And Pat, please don't kill me for this. Craydilly.
Alright.
Oh, Pat.exe is salty. He's so salty.
I believe the Craydilly one is one where I'm gonna be like, oh boy. I watched enough hentai to know where this is going.
Prepare your anus.
No, but I kind of want to save that for Tentacruel.
Yeah, no.
Yeah, save it. Like, also, oh, well done, kid. You finally losing your virginity to a fucking Pokemon.
I can't wait till I... Because the way I do bad...
Here.
The way I do bad decks is I go to a little site called Random Pokemon Generator.
Yeah!
And
well,
I
overwrite.
Literally just
don't
hit generate.
Overwrite.
Well, no, I mean, like,
I
literally,
get,
like...
I want us two to have our episodes.
Well, yeah, I mean, literally, you could come on at any given episode.
Okay, good.
It'll be like,
hey,
what?
Let's do it.
A wild Patt.exe has appeared.
Oh,
right?
My God. You know what her episode is? Litten. Litten's evolution. When Litten's evolution gets revealed, you'll record with her, and you'll be like, what the fuck? This thing's a ground type? And you'll just be so pissed that you'll have to call on the Rotom.
Actually, Litten has a Pokedex entry
about
that already has bad decks. Yeah. Oh, no. No, no, no. We had this other cat on. We peed in my boots, and now we got this thing, and now it shits out fireballs from its mouth.
Okay, let's write an episode of bad decks here, okay? That's your intro segment. Then the kid comes on, and the kid's like, don't worry, bad dick. You don't need to do one for this Pokemon this time. Picks up the cat and, like, is leaving. He's like, hey, where are you going? He's like, I got
oh,
a new
thank God,
I
don't have
deck.
To be with this asshole anymore.
And then you get super jealous when he pulls out the other Pokedex. Oh, wait. Okay. What if he pulls out the smart decks from the earlier episode and you, like, smack it out of his hand and, like, kill it? And then it, like... Weeks later, he gets the new one, and it's the Rotom, and it's fucking with you or whatever. I don't know. I'm overwriting here.
I will say, this is the one thing I have an idea for. Litten, when more stats come out and it's classified and we know more about it, like,
and this will be Arya's
episode. I still need more. That's exactly what I was thinking. Is no, I'm not doing a cat that shits out flaming hairballs. The other one peed in my boots. I'm not dealing with burning down the house and I'm picking up this thing's furballs. And then having the kid go, that's okay, Pokedex. I found a new Pokedex. And then the Rotom comes out. Oh, Jesus Christ. If you think I'm going to deal with a cat and then this thing. And then Arya would be like, the little happy everything going, Jesus Christ.
Arya, look up Litten's Pokedex right now. Like, look up Litten's description.
Wait.
Logically, but also passionate, Litten remains cool-hearted.
Everything's falling out. I've lost my glasses. My headphones are falling out. Oh, no! Okay, I can hear.
So cute.
Litten logically is...
No, I want
logically,
her to read
also...
it in the voice, because she's going to be doing that in
wait,
the video.
Wait, where am I...
Arya, look up Litten's Pokedex entry. The fire starter.
If you could read it like a crackhead, though, that would be spot on.
I am a crackhead.
Perfect.
And you could actually, if we shut the fuck up, we could use her audio for the
Can you send me a link to it? I can't find it. I typed in Litten's Pokedex entry and nothing's come up.
Here we go. I got it.
Ta!
And bam.
Okay. Hurry up and load, you piece of junk. Okay. You mean the Rowlet can attack without making, like, stuff like that?
Yep.
Oh, you're making me read? Oh, shit, I'm really bad at reading.
Perfect.
Rowlet can attack without make... Blah, 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 blah. Fuck.
No, we're doing Litten.
Rowlet can attack without me. Oh, wait, what? Oh, shit.
Litten.
Yeah, we're doing Litten.
I asked about the Rowlet thing, and you were like, yeah. I was like, oh, shit, okay.
High voltage, we'll be silent.
Wait, oh...
Yeah, I'll turn off my mic for this.
Wait, no, don't put this much pressure on me.
Don't worry, just read it in the voice and be cool.
I'm not good at reading.
Just read it really spastically. If you see something, you like find a small sentence interesting, repeat it like 3 times really fast and really hyper.
Okay. Logical, but also passionate. Oh, cool. Little always remains... Cool-headed, he's a cool kitty, and doesn't show his emotions on the surface, just because he's a... Yeah, Litten can attack him with flaming hairballs. Flaming hairballs! It's really... I can't!
That was actually pretty good, because bad decks at this point will be like, oh, Jesus Christ, please tell me they made a gun Pokemon.
I'm sorry, I couldn't handle shit.
totally okay. Oh my god.
Was that good?
I think we should wrap up. I think we can't top that.
Coconut owl.
Alright, how are we going to end this red card episode?
You're very glitchy.
I am a robot.
Alright, high voltage. I'm actually going to give you my phone number so that if we want to talk again, you don't need good internet access.
Perfect. I was actually going to ask you for that, too.
Yeah. Alright, I need to... Yeah, I need to go. I'll be back momentarily, but I'm going to end the recording. So thank you, everyone, for watching. The FullRestore fans have been huge support lately. I'm so glad that you guys are liking the videos and expecting them and everything. Please share this content more, and please keep subscribing. We get about 2 subscribers every month. This is great. And I implore you all to tell me what you want to change in the episodes, what you want helped. I saw that someone commented that you want a list of all the segments in the description of each video. I'm working on that. And overall, keep enjoying yourselves and keep watching all these podcasts from start to finish. Thank you very much. Everyone, sign off.
Is this Roy plug?
You've already plugged, yeah. Arya, you want to plug yourself real quick?
What's plug myself?
Oh, plugging is basically...
That out of context.
Basically, plugging is...
advertise yourself. What do you do? How do people contact you?
Yeah, advertise your YouTube channel or...
I don't have anything. I guess on Twitter. There you go. I do art. I draw anime boobs for a living. There you go. Have fun with that.
Oh my god.
Tell them how to find you.
Just type in weeb in Twitter. No, Aria, at Aria Doodles on Twitter. I draw stuff. Yeah. Go get it. Cool.
Aria,
bye.
I have so many fan requests.
You are paying for every one of them.
All of them.
And she's singing.
Yes. Oh, yeah, I do singing shit, I guess. I don't know.
Alright, everyone, goodbye, everyone! Thank you for listening to this random-ass drunk podcast.
I'm not drunk yet.